Oh my God, I saw this yesterday. Gwyneth Paltrow broke down and ate bread during quarantine. What was your lowest point? Oh no. If I was Gwyneth Paltrow, I'd try so hard to get those articles removed because it just makes her look like a moron. You broke down and ate bread? Oh, poor thing. Think about what other people have gone through during the quarantine. Like there are people who didn't even make it through the quarantine, literally. And there's articles writing about how Gwyneth Paltrow had to eat bread. How is that not just something that happens to you like every 3 days? And it says Gwyneth Paltrow broke down and ate bread. Like broke down in her car or had a breakdown and ate bread. What's wrong with bread? Like I know bread has a lot of carbs in it, but like come on. Oh my God, I had a breakdown and I had to eat bread. How ridiculous. Okay, Cringetopia, let's go. Welcome back, everybody. Hope you're doing fantastic. Thank you so much for tuning back in. And welcome to some cringe. Oh, I can't get over that first post. How silly. Surely the news articles just wrote that in a way to, like, piss everybody off. Like, what the hell? We're gonna have some fun today, guys. It's a beautiful day today. I was just sitting here thinking, you know what? I think we should get cringed out today. So, yeah, I hope you're doing well, and I hope you're ready for this. Enjoy the video. Okay, dream. Tweet spits on you. Swallows, thank you for the meal, daddy dream. Like, I'm 99% sure that that's a joke, but just the thought of somebody saying that unironically makes me upset. If you had a fan base as big as Dream's, like, of course some of them are going to be lunatics. Justin Bieber back in the day, I hate anime. Oh, really? Is it because we got more fans than you? There's cringe inception right now. Like, it's cringy enough that Justin Bieber said that. The bottom part's cringe. I'm cringe, you're cringe, we're all cringe. Unemployed father, 19, with devastate tattooed across half of his face, complains that nobody will employ him. Well, like, you can't really be surprised, can ya? That's a bit ridiculous. Like, are you gonna be a YouTuber now, man? You know, like, I don't want to get devastate across my face, but I've thought about that a lot with tattoos. I don't want face tattoos or nothing. But I was thinking, oh, what if it hinders any of my jobs? And I'm like, oh, wait a second, YouTube doesn't care. We need more of this and less selfies and duck faces. You know, like, yes and no. Like, this is one of those things where it's okay to think it, you know? You go to a mechanic and you see somebody that you didn't expect and it's like, oh, that's cool. But like, to make a meme like this, we need more of this and less selfies and duck faces. And also, the one on the top is a selfie. And like, of course, they're all like super attractive. Like, oh my God, she's so hot. She's working on my car. And like, you can't blame people for not wanting to be like a car mechanic. That's totally up to them. And whether or not you're a guy or a girl, if you're really gorgeous, you probably don't have to do that sort of work if you don't want to. So like, why would you, you know? Another one under Pokimane's tweet. Ready for a vax girl summer? Please spread legs in next picture. I have medical condition and need to see Vagana or I'll die. You know, obviously joking around. But the thing is, how many of Pokimane's tweets would be that, but like completely serious? I'm sure there are so many people. Leonardo DiCaprio, unrecognizable in the first photos of a new Scorsese film. Unrecognizable. It's so obviously Leonardo DiCaprio. He looks exactly like he always does. Unless he's that bowl of food on the table, I disagree. Don't freaking Care Bear. Nah, that's not cringe. I love that. I want an edgy, angry Care Bear. Are you kidding? Those things would fly off the shelves. Like an e-boy, e-girl Care Bear. Oh, I'd like to you-know-what you tonight, baby. Hey, Dad, all of your friends can see when you comment on this stuff.
Oh, that makes me want to cry. Imagine when they see each other next, like, hey.
Hey, you're a weirdo, Dad, and I know it. So screw you, 14-year-old kid. Get owned on by a 35-year-old internet moderator with power and drama at her fingertips. No. A 35-year-old person said that to a 14-year-old? I hope not. That's so sad. How could you write that? that and think you sounded cool. So screw you, 14-year-old kid. Get owned on by a 35-year-old internet moderator with power and drama at her fingertips. Oh my god. This vehicle is equipped with a millennial anti-theft device. Get it? Because apparently nobody can drive a manual. This one actually annoys me because there aren't a lot of car manufacturers that even make manuals anymore. Like, if you go and try and buy a brand new car right now, it's actually kind of hard to find a manual. You know, like, everybody just wants to make auto cars. It's actually not all their fault, you know? And maybe that's all they have is an automatic. Oh, it's such a weird thing to brag about. I've never understood that. And like, there are a lot of guys that think they're somehow manlier because they know how to change gears. That doesn't make any sense. Do you love me? Of course, why not? More than anime? Know your place, you 3D girl. Nah, this one's not cringe, you know? I 100%, no, I'm only joking. I don't agree. 2D girls are not better than 3D girls. Oopsie, just made sweet consensual love to a dog. Stay mad, folks. Hashtag zoo pride, hashtag zoophilia, and two other ones that I probably can't say. Are they joking? Surely they're joking. Yeah, guys, I'm just gonna say that they're joking. They're not. I don't know what to say. I don't have any advice for stuff like this. I'm just gonna go delete Twitter. I'll be right back. Just another day learning numbers and about hashtag flat earth and hashtag the moon landing didn't happen, kid. Oh my god, love. So cute. Like, yeah, maybe the photo's cute, but teaching your kid that the moon landing didn't happen and that the earth is flat, that's evil. Like, how dare you? And like, they think they're being cute and adorable. Like, oh yes, the earth is flat. Like, just teaching them nonsense. How do you think that's ever gonna help your kids? Oh, she can grow up and be a Facebook warrior like I am. Yeah, some things I really don't understand. 2020, we only serve people with face masks. 2021, we only serve people with COVID passes. 2022, we only serve people with microchips. Microchips, delicious. I want some barbecue ones. Yeah, everything on Facebook's a bloody conspiracy. Like, oh my god, soon they'll only accept people who have microchips. They're turning us into robots. Buddy, calm down. I wish you liked me back. Your girlfriend does? Don't bring her up. I'm talking about us. Why don't you like me? Oh, you're saying that to somebody when you have a girlfriend. These people are bad. I don't like people like that. Don't put your partner through this sort of stuff. Like, if you're gonna be like this, break up, end it now. Don't string somebody along if you're gonna talk to other people. That's so wrong. I'm a morning person, but I don't eat breakfast. That's kind of overindulging. I just drink tea and do my morning workout and eat lunch and dine, and I'm done for the day. Oh, and sorry if I use words that you don't understand. Don't be scared to Google it. Bro, what are they gonna Google? You don't even bloody capitalize your sentences. And you're acting like you're a genius that they can't understand. Oh my. That's really funny. I probably would keep talking to this guy just because he's funny. He's been trying to kiss her all lunch, friend zoned him to the max. Oh, and he's going in for a kiss and she's laughing. I'm gonna die of embarrassment over here. But dude, you need to be able to know when she's not interested. And she's laughing, it's obvious. So like, don't keep trying, it's so weird. I don't know if it's a neckbeard thing or a nice guy thing, but a lot of guys think it's a really nice and romantic thing to not give up on a girl like that. But if they have no interest in you, it's rude to keep trying. I just feel bad because you know he's like, oh my god, I love you with all my heart. You're the only girl I ever want. He'll probably look back on that in like 10 years time and be like, oh my god, what was I doing? You asked why I licked you inch by devious inch. What I lick is mine. You have been licked. You are all mine. Every beautifully dark inch of you, mine. Oh, this video's been really hard to film. I hope you guys are enjoying it, and I hope you're not too terrified. And on that note, I think we should check out some wholesome memes. Me pretending to be dead. My little brother thinking I actually died. Dude, oh my god, I have a story for you guys. guys. When I was really young, like under 10, my sister chased me into my parents' bedroom, right? And like we used to wrestle and fight and stuff like all kids do. And she was like trying to smother me with this pillow. And I was just going nuts. Like I was kicking and screaming and all the rest of it. Like I wasn't actually in danger or nothing. Just sort of having fun. And then I just sort of stopped kicking and just laid there. And she ran out crying because she thought she'd bloody killed me. Yeah. And I just walk out of there and I'm like, hello, I'm a zombie. I have risen from the dead. Good times. Me cleaning my room. A toy I lost years ago. Oh, hi. Mum didn't throw you out. I got so angry at my parents because I thought they threw my toys away. But it turns out they were underneath all my clothes. Thank you for changing my life. I'm literally a sunny afternoon after work. Yeah, it's actually insane how much the weather changes your mood. Like, I think about this all the time. Every time we have a really nice sunny day, or like it's really wintry and awful and you feel a little bit sad, it's like, oh, it's probably just the weather. Sometimes that's all it is. As you guys know, I'm into archery. The ultimate best time to shoot my bow is one of those late sunny afternoons where it's super dry and there's no like wind or nothing. And it's like the perfect temperature and the sun looks really nice. That sort of stuff makes you happy for sure. All right, that's going to do it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you got cringed out today or you had fun, make sure you like, make sure you subscribe, all that fun stuff. And let's do the comment of the day. And it goes to MC Scrubs. First, it was the Simpsons references. Now it's the SpongeBob references. Guys, he is evolving. Oh, yeah, I am. I don't know that many SpongeBob references, but I do know a good amount. Nothing could ever top my Simpsons knowledge, but I'll try my best. All right, guys, have a wonderful rest of your day. Have a wonderful night. And yeah, look after yourself. You're the best. I'll see you guys tomorrow.